Hi Phil.
Hi.
Well, it must be an exciting day for you to see this, the result of your work.
Yes, very pleased it's completed and everyone seems happy with it.
Can you just talk us through the process of the concept through to us being here today?
Ray Bridges and the people involved with the Newcomb Society approached me and asked me if I could design them something to go on this island specifically to celebrate 300 years. Mm-hmm. So we came up with a few concepts and this is the one they liked the best. The idea being that the modern look of it is directly opposed to the old engine itself. It's the contrast between the two, the old and the new. That's what they wanted. I came up with the idea of the material, which is an aluminium composite, so it won't rust or hopefully won't decompose in any way, shape or form, and look nice and modern and clean. Yeah, it's the entrance to Dartmouth, hopefully. Someone suggested it will be now known as the Newcomen Island, or Newcomen Roundabout.
Very good.
Which would be nice.
And would you like to just say something about your company while you're...
Always. Deep Blue Signs is the company.
Thank you very much.
It's a pleasure.
Thank you.
Okay.
Yes.
It's nice to talk to another Derbyshire girl.
Ladies and gentlemen, pray silent for Mr. Ray Bridges, the chairman of the Newcomen 300 Group.
Look, it's the first time I've heard anybody hanging on my every word. That's really rather nice, makes a change. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. It is fantastic that you have come out in such large numbers and we're thrilled to bits. And we've laid on the weather for you so that it's really nice to see you today. And we hope you're all going to enjoy what we have to show to you. And also hope you're all going to join in with the dancing afterwards. You will love it. Thomas Newcomen was the genius who invented the first working engine in the world. And Dartmouth is the place where he was born and bred and invented the engine. The engine here, this very engine, is the oldest engine in the world. And it is quite likely that Thomas Newcomen himself played an important part in building it. It is the oldest engine in the world. Just bear that in mind. And so we felt it important to celebrate his tercentenary, and there has been a lot of work done by a lot of people to get here. And you are actually standing on the mini plaza that has been created by Southam's team. And I just want to say here that we're here today to celebrate his genius by building this plaza, by having this engine house totally refurbished by a very special group of people. And I hope that you can join in and celebrate with all of us today. And to help kick off the celebrations, we have with us the chairman of the South Hams District Council, and she has been newly appointed, Councillor Rosemary Rowe. Please give her a big welcome.
I didn't expect to see so many people. It's like, wow, but some of you will be residents and some of you are probably on holiday, yes? All those of you that are on holiday, wave your hands and then we'll know who you are. Ah, right. No, you're not on holiday. Right. And you're enjoying the wonderful weather here in Dartmouth. And it's like this all the time. First of all, I'd like to thank Ray and his team for inviting myself and my husband, Tony, here this evening. We always enjoy coming to Dartmouth, and I regard Dartmouth as a jewel in the crown of the South Hams. It is a one absolutely wonderful place. And when we were coming across on the ferry a little while ago, I said to my husband, you don't need to go anywhere else in the world. There's nowhere else exactly like Dartmouth. And I'm sure that those of you who live here appreciate that. And those of you who visit from time to time, please come back and visit Dartmouth again. It's nice to have had this project moved forward with the backing of Dartmouth Town Council and my own council, it's South Hams. The park is always so beautifully maintained and is a credit to all those who work and keep it in good shape. And also, to the ward members of the District Council. I know Hilary is here today, and also Jonathan and Melvin, who represent Dartmouth, and of course young Ben Cooper, who also represents Dartmouth on the District Council. We have so much to celebrate this year. We've just had the Olympic torch going through Dartmouth on Sunday. I expect lots of you turned out to see that. I've been shown some pictures of, I think it was a blind man who ran or went through Dartmouth so far with the torch. And I think he must be congratulated. And we've got all the flags up in the TIC, the Tourist Information Centre, looking forward to the Queen's Golden Jubilee in Diamond Jubilee, 60 years, the Diamond Jubilee in less than 2 weeks' time. For us here today, we are celebrating 300 years of Thomas Newcome, a local resident who invented the steam engine and started the Industrial Revolution, which changed the world and started the Age of Steam. And I wonder what he would think if he could come back today and see the progress that's been made from then on. And even in our lifetimes, everything is changing all the time. So goodness knows what it would be like in another 300 years' time. It probably doesn't bear thinking about. This corner of the garden has been transformed, and we've got the lovely plaza that's been laid down by the council. And also there's been new trees planted. I don't actually see them, but I've not seen them yet anyway. And also the seats which have been provided for many visitors and local residents alike. We look forward to seeing the engine, and maybe, I don't know if it's going to be started up tonight or not, and the display, which is going to be given by the young dancers with their aptly named Steam Heat Dance. So that sounds quite interesting, doesn't it? Well, I'd like to thank you all of you for coming and enjoying the lovely weather, and I wish you all well, and thank you for inviting us. Thank you, Ray. Thank you.
Main funders for this whole project. You've just heard from the most important person from one of them, South Ham District Council, and the other main funder, and they both worked very closely together over this entire period, is Dartmouth Town Council. And I think we should give Dartmouth Town Council a big vote of thanks, and I would like to introduce a new mayor, newly reappointed mayor, should I say, Paul Allen. Give him a big welcome, please.
Mr. Chairman, Madam Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, and also my newly appointed Deputy Mayor, on behalf of the town, it is a great privilege not only to live here, but to actually represent this town. And I think this is a wonderful example of the District Council, South Hams District Council, and the Town Council, and a group of volunteers, chaired by Ray, actually working for a common purpose, and that's what we're very good at, no matter what else we do. And I do thank you all for your support. And I know certainly that for the future, Ray and his committee would look for as many advocates as possible. And I know Councillor Corley has put something on an electronic thing today for the thing that's been opened at the top of town. But if you could actually advertise and talk about and email and Twitter and Facebook, Dartmouth, but in particular Thomas Newcombe, would be most grateful. So can I say to Southampton District Council, thank you very much. But can I say a special thank you to Hilary Baston, because he's been a mover and shaker, and I'm personally most grateful for everything that Hilary's done for us. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Thomas Newcombe was an inventor who used steam and a piston to pump water out of mines. That's what he did, and he revolutionized mining entirely. And that was 300 years ago. To open our engine house today officially, we have another inventor who uses a piston to pump water uphill. This time using wave power to generate green energy with his invention called the Sea Razor Wave Pump. Please welcome another Dartmouth inventor, ready to benefit the world, Alvin Smith. Yeah.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, girls and boys, and Mayor, Lady Councillor. Yes, when I walk the hills around Dartmouth here to get the inspiration, I often think, did Thomas Newcombe walk in these very steps? Dartmouth presents you with that inspiration, gives you the determination to go on, and I'm sure he would have spent many, many months, if not years, building his knowledge, overcoming the problems that he had to solve to make this incredible engine, the very first in the world, powered by steam. I think Dartmouth can be very, very proud of this engineer when you think anyone in the world could have invented it, but the guy was born just over there, just off the quay in Dartmouth, in, I believe, the National Trust shop now, before the house was moved along to Higher and Lower Street. So with this chap that's done so well in the world, providing all the mechanical right through to what's been followed right through to Formula One, when you see these cars revving at over 20,000 revolutions per minute, coming from this original engine using a reciprocating piston, I think we can be extremely proud. The other thing I would like to say is thank you to everybody in Dartmouth, the townspeople, everybody that lives in the area. I've had enormous support with my invention. People have been extremely friendly. They've put up with me making noises in the night and floating around in the river with different structures and so on. And I thank you for that. I've only lived in Dartmouth 15 years. I feel now I've lived here a lifetime. It's everybody's so friendly. So thank you very much indeed for that. So I think it's probably time to open the plaza now and dedicate this Dartmouth's very own engineer, Thomas Newcombe.
There we go. And he's even brought his own scissors.
Yes, a Boy Scout, so come on.
Everybody happy? Everybody?
Okay, one, two, three. There we go. There she goes. Many thanks, Alvin. And now, just before you go to enjoy yourselves dancing, I should like to invite someone up here to make a presentation to a person who's been vitally important to what you see here today. This person has literally been responsible for revamping the whole of the designs in the engine house and masterminding a team of people in changing its appearance and making it what it is. And I would like to invite Councillor Hilary Baston to come and make a presentation.
Just before I do, just like to repeat a few things that have been said, one of which is I'd like to thank the newcoming group for their support in putting this plaza down, but also I'd like to thank the two councils who've made this possible, and also for the team at South Hams District Council who've worked extremely hard on this. Keith Reynolds, who was the mastermind, is not here today, but Andy Smythe, who actually designed it, is with us today, and I thank Andy. I'd like to thank the gardeners who've put in a supreme effort in the last few days. Yes. We've had to wait for the rain to stop. But they have created something here that was beyond my dreams in the first place. And I apologise to Nigel Way for cutting down that 90-year-old oak tree. It was a shame, but I think we've created something special here today. But when we had our first meetings here in this darkened corner, as it was then, there was one inspiration, and that was Angela White. So Angela, for all that you've done for not only the Engine House, but the inspiration you gave us for creating this, please accept this small token. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you now go to the bandstand where you will be entertained by some fabulous dancers? God save the Queen! God
So today we're very privileged with the opening of the Newcomen Engine House to meet two inventors, Thomas Newcomen and Elvin Smith. And I wondered if, gentlemen, you could tell us, what is your inspiration for being an inventor? Thomas, would you like to start first?
Inspiration is a necessity. It's a necessity, which is, everyone knows, Elvin's the mother of invention. I'm sure you'll see that. Very true.
So your idea was to be able to get water from the mines, and that was the big challenge.
That's right, pumping water uphill, because so many miners were killed and children were killed going down the mines in their teens, and 8 and 9 year old children, and the idea was to pump the water out so to make their job safer.
Sure.
And of course get out the coal.
More coal.
Yeah.
Incredibly, my invention has similarities with yours, because we are pumping water. We're using the swell and the rise of the ocean as the waves pass through to lift a buoy on the surface, and then we're using gravity to force the piston down,
like a water mill,
and push the water up. So it's very, very similar.
Like a water mill, would it be?
You could call it a water mill, but it's a piston, it's a reciprocating piston, just like yours.
Ah.
But you used fire and steam, we're using wave and swell energy.
The impellent force of fire is the patent.
And the necessity in our case, we want to make electricity. In your case, you wanted to lift water to clear the mines.
Well, so many horses as well, of course, were needed to pull water up uphill before the invention of my reciprocating steam engine.
Yes.
And they could all be put to the fields and use the impellent force of fire.
Fantastic. But the admiration I have for you, the very first engine in the world using a piston, even to Formula One today, they're still using pistons. Your invention has come through 300 years and it's still there.
Formula One, what pray is Formula One?
Well, we are as fascinated by your engine as you are probably as fascinated by a Formula One engine.
I'd love to see these Formula One that you speak of.
Thank you very much. Okay. So today, Thomas Newcomen has become an international star in Dartmouth, from Dartmouth.
300 years old today, my engine, yes.
Thank you very much.
Excellent.
Thank you,
okay.
Thank
no
you.
Problem.
Yes, and we have the engine that changed the world, Thomas Newcomen. Wally knows all about that.
It's the 300th anniversary of the world's first working steam engine. I mean, he was the inventor of steam engines. There were various other things around, but they weren't in the sense of an engine part of it now. People tend to remember the steam engine in terms of the railway engine and Stevenson, but of course that wouldn't have happened without our own Dartmouthian, Thomas Newcomen, who was born just to the south end of the town here. And to say, we're not quite sure when he was born, there's no records of that, but this year celebrates, to say, the 300th anniversary of the first working engine, which went on, of course, to pump most of the mines, the deep mines in the country out, and in other parts of the world. A very important person who'd been sadly overlooked.
So did the Industrial Revolution really start in Dartmouth?
That's our play on this one, the man who kick-started the Industrial Revolution. Without steam, everybody else that came along, they refined the steam engine, but they didn't actually invent it.
Well, thanks very much. Good luck with the collection, and have a lovely celebration.
Lovely,
and a great Jubilee year.
Great, thanks for watching.